Sheet System West Africa was live on Citizen Business Center tonight. Eric, thank you so much for joining us. I know earlier I've been mentioning that you're 29 and you've been very quick to say, no, I'm 30. So I stand corrected. Now, so you started supplying eggs at the age of 22 to schools. And I'm just curious, at the age of 22, most young people are either pursuing education or they're looking for a job. Was that the beginning of Eric, the entrepreneur?
Yes, I did that myself. I was 22 years old. I just completed college and I was working on a night shift teaching D&D. So I had a lot of free time to work at the first work up. I started doing marketing as a little place. I just found out that I didn't give this company. I put in this big farm. And I'm doing behalf of one team. So I got some orders. I could get even $25 per week. Then the guy would be selling the edition.
So, and then you started supplying computers and other things as well to the same schools?
No, to those hotels, not to schools.
So, to the hotels?
Yes, came up to the
yes.
After post-election programs, the president wanted to get some credit. We have a lot of people approach schools, come up and they say, schools are nice. Not only computers, big kind of stationaries, uniforms. But when I was doing that, I bought a motor of a tent. He came back to me and was trying to source for it. It was very hard. It was most of the companies that were in that time were importing. I could see there was a gap. I did a lot of research. Simple as it, I did a lot of research. Unfortunately, it's a hard thing. But I see there was a gap.
Okay, so that was the beginning of Shades. So after that one order of the tent, you decided to set up a company to manufacture and supply tents. How has the business grown since then?
The business has grown well, but there have been a lot of challenges, especially in manufacturing. There's a lot of challenges, a lot of that between the two. We need a good demand resource. It's very hard to put up the courage and results in there. We should have that intellect of doing for ourselves, working on factoring. We should go for manufacturing, not importing. Because at the present, we need to some strategy. We are making up the other two products. We need to manufacture things and export instead of designing on importing. Because we have many people that are talking of importing and getting. We need to manufacture. But say, we have our 1 billion market. Only that we are able to sustain them, please attach that with a great opportunity to support. We have through my dreams, I've been able to see in terms of skill level, we are the best in the world.
But you're so young, Eric, and I'm just wondering, you know, you're here talking about we should be able to manufacture our own products and not necessarily import them. What kind of challenges did you face, first of all, as a young entrepreneur? Because I assume at that time you were about 24 when you began. So what were the challenges you faced at the time?
The greatest challenge was capital. But for me, I never said, capital is money. The greatest capital is an idea. If you have an idea, if you have the determination, if you are capital yourself, you will approach it. Then you can tell you, but now, go talk to suppliers. It will be hard, it will be simple. You have to be the foundation, be the right people, the right. You have to get the foundation because most of the young people in the world, you register a company, then you go and tender for something. You have to be a success, you have to
I'm curious about that because I was reading online about you. I mean, the dailies, and one of them said that you actually approached a Shylock and took a one million shilling loan from the Shylock. You know, some people would say that is extreme risk or even a point of naivety, but some people would say that is extreme passion. How was that experience?
That was the most decision I ever made because I've spent a lot of time in interest. It was not a one of maybe even what I did, but a 1 million as a professional. I don't know if it led, maybe a lot of something. For me, Sherlock is going to be.
So, how do you advise young people who share the same challenges that you did when they started? And they say capital is usually the biggest problem. where do you start? Say you're 22 or you're 23 or you're 24 and you have an idea. What is the best way to start a business today?
First of all, then if you want to get people back to the business, because one thing, as I said before, is not about registering the company.
East Africa is now exporting to Somalia, to Congo, I understand to Rwanda as well, among other countries. How did you strike the deals, the international deals? Because usually in Kenya we say, you know, we supply to those that we know. How did you strike those international deals?
One thing, as I said, we are back as China, because of this East Africa, we don't have the skills of functioning of the business of the world. And we've got to have the market.
Alright, tell us about your other businesses. I know you have a home cleaning service and you're now getting into the manufacturing of that as well.
Home cleaning service, home support services, and professionalize it, whereby we provide a professional service to home support services.
You're very passionate about mentoring young people as well. And when once I posted on Twitter that you were here tonight, a lot of young people were asking about mentorship. Tell us about that.
Through the experience I want to ask you all to be able to do it. It's not just one that is a journey. It's still a small journey. It's still a journey. I want to go. So for me, as part of giving back to the community, I linked a lot. I have a Facebook page.
Started, and how can young people today find a mentor to help them through their different entrepreneurship journeys?
The initial part of my business life, the part of my personal life, which is the hardest thing, that's what I want to give back. But now I have people today, older people today, who don't have this in this video. You have to have someone to guide you, you have to have someone to mentor. Yes.
As we wind up, Eric, I know you told me not to ask you about the money issues, but I'm just wondering, how does it feel to be named as one of Africa's youngest millionaires?
Okay.
we pray that you will. All right, Eric, thank you so much for joining us tonight. That's Eric Kinoti, the CEO of Shade System East Africa, who has been sharing with us his entrepreneurial journey from supplying eggs to hotels to a businessman of about three or four different enterprises. And that's it for tonight. Thank you so much, Eric, for being on the Business Center.